Hello and welcome to the Kiss Kiss Bang Bang New Music Files. We've been expecting you. I'm your host, Uncle Agent 0013 Dead Air Dave, and in each episode, we open the dossier on a band to find out the intel on their latest release and what they're up to. And on this, our inaugural podcast in association with Osiris Media, we're opening the file on JOYWAVE and our guest, Daniel Armbruster. Welcome to the Kiss Kiss Bang Bang New Music Files, Dan.
Wow, thank you for having me. Everything around here in the high-budget studio where we're sitting right now is so impeccable that I can't believe that this is the inaugural episode, and I'm truly honored.
Yes, you will forever be remembered in the annals of the Kiss Kiss Bang Bang as number one.
I mean, this is big tech venture capital fund money around here supporting this thing.
Yeah, you can tell, can't you? That's where we blow the budget on the snacks.
Wow, yeah, the snacks were unbelievable.
So Dan, I wonder, before we really get into the latest, because this is the new music file, while we certainly want to hear about the origin of JOYWAVE, we're going to focus today about your new release that's coming up. But I have to also tell you that in the Dead Air Dave household, now that we've just gotten out of the holiday season, every year our tradition includes this incredible JOYWAVE Christmas tree ornament that is adorned with your lovely mug on the side. So I just
Thank
want you.
You
to know.
And I want you to know that my tree also has that, and I work very hard to put it at the very top every year. And it is frowned upon. There is either a star or a baby that goes up there, and it's not me.
Well, let's work on seeing if we can't get a JOYWAVE star so that your face can be at the top of the tree legitimately.
That'd be great.
It would be fantastic. Something to shoot for 2022. The new album is Cleanse, but before we jump right into that, give everybody a quick, everything they need to know about JOYWAVE from your origins in Rochester.
JOYWAVE, it's three guys who all went to high school together in Rochester, New York, and we are lucky to still be doing this many, many years later, and on our fourth record. It's pretty fun, and sometimes you can lose sight of how remarkable that is. There's not a long list of people with successful music careers from Rochester, New York. It's pretty short, and we kind of did that without knowing anybody. We just kept putting things out until someone was like, hey, this is pretty good.
Right on. And later in our podcast, we're going to check in with some radio and find out how a radio station in Buffalo was a key player in helping you guys along that way. And before we jump into the brand new song, in the butt smooching, the guest category, I would be remiss if I didn't tell you that to this day, one of my all-time favorite music videos is yours for Like a Kennedy.
Oh, thank you very much.
The concept is really engaging and very impactful. The visuals are amazing. It was a beautifully shot video, and now it looks like it's a continuous one-shot segment. Yes. And I know there are two versions of that. The, shall we say, less bloody version and the more so version.
Well, you're going to get in trouble with the radio guy when he comes on now, because I'm pretty sure there's only one.
You know, you're right. I must have seen that in a fever dream or something. But anyway,
anybody who has not seen the video, and I don't know who that would be, but I recommend wholeheartedly that you go search out JOYWAVE's video for Like a Kennedy.
I think there may be 7 to 8 billion people who haven't seen it, but we actually shot that in the UK on an RAF airbase there, like a retired one that they use for film shoots now, and my uncle served in the Air Force, and when I was born, he was on that base serving in the UK, which I kind of figured out that day. I sent him a picture and a text message. I said, have you ever been here? I know you were, you know, in the UK at one point. And he was like, yeah, that's, you know, the day you were born where I was stationed. So
wow,
pretty crazy.
So you didn't go into it knowing that. You discovered
I found it out. Yeah, I found it out, you know, when I was getting into the car for the next take.
It's a fantastic video, and I really do recommend everybody check it out, really.
Thank you.
Let's move on now to what's going on in new music for you guys. The new album is Cleanse. How did this come about, and what's the mindset on that?
Well, there happened to be a virus going around. I don't know how many listeners out there are familiar. And our last record came out on March 13th, 2020. It was called Possession. It had the song Like a Kennedy on it. And it turns out that was the worst day ever to release an album. And basically half the people who were supposed to be working that album got furloughed from the record label and all the promotional teams and stuff. We were unable to tour. It was crazy. And, you know, I know a lot of artists say, you know, music is a form of therapy for them. And it's definitely the thing that I latch onto when my life or things around me don't make sense. So I didn't know what else to do besides write music, given the time. I mean, I obsessed over CNN total case counts for like 3 weeks. We were actually on tour in Europe when it broke out, and we flew back from Germany, I think, on March 1st or 2nd, and we flew into Newark, and there was a border agent who asked me if I had been to Wuhan, and I said no, and he had no follow-up questions.
And it was like, all he needed.
Right, right, on this particular day, the guy who used to be president was on TV saying that, you know, we're checking temperatures at the border, we're doing, and there it, no, there was nothing. So I came home, my girlfriend picked me up from the airport, we purchased all of the cat food. She's like, how long do you think this is gonna last? You know, as I'm like, I've got like boxes, I'm like, you have no idea. So I didn't know what else to do. And there was also this thing that kind of came over me of like, I'm okay with traveling, but I get motion sickness very easily, and when I take Dramamine for it, it really bums me out and gets me down. And when you're kind of in that like haze trying not to throw up, it right. can be hard to feel, you know, like I said, fortunate about like, wow, people from the suburbs of Rochester, New York getting paid because people want to hear their music in Europe and go play on these, like, I'd never been there before, you know, right, music right. took me there. And in the moment, sometimes it's hard to feel lucky or excited when you're really tired. And being home, there was kind of this clarity of like, for the first time we slowed down, it wasn't like, there was just nothing on the calendar, you know? It wasn't like, all right, here's a couple weeks to record, but then you go fly to this show, then you go fly to this thing, then you go fly to this thing. Right. None of that.
It was wide open for you.
Right, so I was able to reflect and kind of feel lucky, and a lot of the new record reflects that, and I think is maybe a little more optimistic than things we've done in the past, a little less complainy, because... Yeah, I mean, it was a terrible and is a terrible time for the world, but like, I just stayed home and made music. That's really not so bad.
Right. Like when life's trucking along, it's easy to complain about the littlest things. But when we're in circumstances like this, you become pretty grateful about what you have.
Mm-hmm.
For the position you were in of being healthy and being able to continue making your music.
Right. And I think it's the thing, too, where... you will always have problems. You will always find a problem. Something will always be wrong, but be grateful for the one that you have, because it could be so much worse. And if things are humming along, you're like, I can't believe that the snacks here today on the podcast were Fritos. I don't like Fritos. Unless Fritos is a sponsor of the program here, in which case,
no,
I
you're
love
clear, you're clear. You're good.
Fritos.
Okay. In this new body of work on Cleanse, tell us a little bit about this first song that we're going to be rolling out to people called Buy American.
Very excited for people to hear this one. I really wanted to make a giant campaign rally song where idiots could take it at face value and get really amped up. But if you listen even remotely closely, you will discover the lyrics are satirical. And it's a lot of bad advice. You know how it is. I mean, everyone's in a camp, and everyone outside of their camp doesn't deserve compassion or understanding or anything else, right? And it's, we've got like scientists trying to solve problems and politicians trying to solve problems. And at this point, I think we just need a really good therapist. Like America should just hire one therapist to kind of point out like, hey, you know, we're actually despite all these things, we're together and there's nothing any of us can do about it. So here's how we can get along instead of screaming for the other person to change their mind, which isn't going to happen and just, you know, reinforces bad opinions.
Okay, I'm with you on this. I'm going to start writing letters to the White House that we need a national therapist.
This country needs a therapist.
That was a great, that's the best idea I've heard yet, Dan.
Thank you.
So on that note, we are going to right now dig in and listen to a little bit of Buy American from JOYWAVE right here on the Kiss Kiss Bang Bang New Music Files. And from their soon-to-be-released album, Cleanse, that is a taste of Buy American from JOYWAVE on the Kiss Kiss Bang Bang New Music Files. I'm Dead Air Dave, and now joining Daniel and I is Bentley from 103.3 The Edge in Buffalo.
Fellow Western New Yorker, too. Very, very exciting.
Yes.
Are you guys in the same zip code?
No.
No.
I don't know. I'm a California kid. I have no idea.
Three zip codes between us right now? I don't really know.
Yeah, maybe same temperature.
Okay, yeah, I think that's probably accurate.
Okay, so Bentley, earlier Dan had mentioned that, you know, this band from Rochester that no one knew had to find footing and build their way up, and radio was a part of that, and The Edge was significantly a part of that.
So I have a history with a couple stations with this band, and the funny thing is I know what I'm supposed to say, and I know what people in radio say, and honestly, JOYWAVE came up with, even if nobody knew where they were from, they were just undeniable. So we want to say that we, you know, obviously we're going to latch on to somebody that's from our area and we're going to claim that and be really proud of it. But even in Western New York, JOYWAVE raised their hand on their own with all of the other artists out there at that time. So if it was just another band from the area that wasn't good, we wouldn't be here right now. So I do like to say, for as much as I love to claim other people's talent and take ownership of that, I remember an instance before this station where a JOYWAVE single was played, and I'm like, JOYWAVE, I think they're from Rochester. So it's not like when we're presented this music or anybody in the area, it's like, well, these guys are from Rochester, you should probably play them. You know, they stood out totally on their own. And then, of course, we use and abuse them. And
Dan, do you feel abused?
No. I think it's really interesting because you would think local places support their own kind of automatically, and in a mid-sized to small city, sometimes the opposite is true, where people may ask themselves, are we just playing this because they're from here? And for us early on, I think we had more support in Buffalo than Rochester, maybe for the first, like, few months or so, because we've played local venues in Rochester for years and years and years, and we did okay in Rochester. You know, we had our like core 200 people who would come to the show and who were like, you guys don't understand, this band is incredible. Not just like, you know, a good local band, like they're actually like great, and everyone else is like, right, but they're from Rochester, so it's not good. Right, because like there's just this mentality in like a mid-sized or small city of like, man, I just got to get out of here, which I think is completely flawed. You know, we all still live in Rochester; it's a great place. But what we saw was that things started to go well for us in like New York and Chicago and L.A., and all these people in those places started talking to friends that they knew who were from Rochester and said, you know about this band, right? And all these people are like, oh, yeah. No, I knew all about him. No, I definitely knew about him.
Sure, and they all suddenly went to high school with you and knew you way back then.
Exactly. And it's a bummer because, like, I think that JOYWAVE has actually helped change that perception that, like, nothing good can come from my hometown. And I hope that it continues to change and evolve because people were like, oh, people like this in other places. Okay. And now, I mean, now, you know, in Rochester, we get amazing support, and sure. in Buffalo, we get amazing support.
Bentley, what do you say?
I'm gonna go on that location thing, because I also feel like when you guys first really popped, now you were working real hard before that too. Like, let's not underplay that, like downplay that. You were out doing shows. There were, you know, blogs writing about you. There was this undercurrent already bubbling. But then what I noticed that a lot of artists weren't doing yet, and now, like you said, you've changed it. They weren't saying they were from an area of New York. They were saying right. New York, because they wanted to be associated with New York City.
Yep.
And I feel like in that time, you guys were maybe one of the first bands saying, no, we're from Rochester. And, you know, we have bands now coming to Buffalo to record. I mean, the pandemic, obviously, there was a mass exodus out of New York. But how did you decide to do that? And is that part of your identity and part of your music? Because you are so honest, and you do have a satire to your music, but it's also very honest. Like, what part of that made you not be like, no, we're not going to say from New York. We're New York City. We're, you know, from Rochester.
Yeah. I mean, I think we had, before JOYWAVE, me, Paul, and Joey had done like a local band in Rochester that didn't work. And like it that did very well, like locally. We were like a big local band. And all these people would tell us like, you got to do this, you got to do this, you got to do this. And we'd be like, oh, well, that person definitely knows what they're talking about. You know, let's try that. Let's try that. Let's try that. And eventually we just like struck out completely. And I was kind of like, okay, we have failed. You know, music is not going to happen for me as like a career, but like as an artist, I still have to make things. So that was kind of the genesis of JOYWAVE. And the rules were like, we're going to do whatever we want to do whenever we want to do it. The idea of like being deceitful about where we were from or trying to claim New York or something, like, honestly didn't really cross our minds. It's just kind of not who we are. But so much of coming up as a band, like, there's so much music out there. And especially if you're from a non-New York, non-LA place, it's really hard to get noticed. And one of the things that helps you get noticed is an interesting story, right? Like, this person is the child of this person, or like, this person is whatever, right? Like, it's facts like that. And we were really boring to a lot of people. Like, I don't think that we're boring, like if you talk to us or listen to the band or anything,
but you didn't,
like,
have that good story.
No, there was no, right, there was no story. It's like these three guys have known each other since high school and they're from the suburbs, and like, okay, like, right, that could be any band. And then without realizing it, like, this band is from Rochester, isn't that weird, became like the thing.
That became cool.
Other people made it a thing because there were some early stories about the band where it was like Brooklyn indie band JOYWAVE, and we were like, no, you got it wrong, we're from Rochester. And they're like, oh, Rochester, isn't that interesting.
Well, you know what, I love that, and I love your sense of humor, and I love that you still brought your satire into the new song By American. So I'm glad you haven't lost that touch.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bentley from The Edge in Buffalo, thanks so much for that lead-in, because we heard By American. But Dan, I'm hoping you can pick another song off the album for us.
Oh, great. Well, I was talking a little bit about that ability to reflect and be grateful. And there was a fair amount of, you know, like, the worst thing you can do is compare yourself to someone else or another artist, or how things are going for this person over here. It's like perpetual unhappiness. The song Sin City 2000 from the record kind of deals with a lot of those feelings.
So here you go on Kiss Kiss Bang Bang New Music Files.
The last idea I had got swallowed by a black hole. I could cure cancer, but they give the prize to some asshole.
And we're back on the Kiss Kiss Bang Bang New Music Files. Today, we have opened the JOYWAVE file, and Dan is here. Dan, Armbruster. Now, you know, when you were a kid, like in junior high or high school, did your buddies give you a nickname? Did they call you Armbuster? Because that's a badass name. If I had hung out with you, I'd have been like, here comes the Armbuster.
Thank you. I think there were several people who would say something like that to me before shoving me into a locker in the gymnasium.
You were more the recipient of the arm busting.
It's technically Armbruster, but you did exactly what the mean kids at school did, and I have to go.
Oh, no, quick. Yeah, to save the day from Hollywood Records, Buddy Deal joins us now in the conversation. Buddy, quick, don't let Daniel go.
No, I got him. I got him by the neck.
Okay, great. Buddy, that's your cue.
Oh, my name is Buddy Deal, and I am the rock and alternative guy at Hollywood Records for radio promotion. So,
I just got an oat latte delivered to me. My girlfriend just dropped this off.
Let Buddy promote JOYWAVE once again, and just know that there is JOYWAVE.
JOYWAVE, yeah.
Coffee made by JOYWAVE.
Mm-hmm.
Is that
this
right?
Is true.
Yeah, we did it with a local coffee shop. I think it's on our website, but yeah, it's called JOYWAVE Delightful Beans. It's a mix of Ethiopia and kind of a rotating cast of South American origins together. It's great.
The rotating cast is what makes the difference.
Mm-hmm.
How much did you learn about coffee in the process of this, Dan?
Well, we actually did a local taste testing. This is going back to like 2014 or 15. And we had the coffee shop put together two different blends that they were trying. And then the third one was literally Folgers. No one picked Folgers except for my grandma came. Because, you know, she heard free coffee and she was like, I like number three. That one tastes like coffee to me. And it was just straight up pour over, but Folgers.
Yeah, yeah. Because that's what grandma knows.
Grandma knows cigarettes and coffee.
There you go. Palmols and Folgers.
Yes, yes.
Fantastic. So, Buddy, is there any insight you want to give us from the record label side of this equation?
You know, there are a lot of different avenues I could go down.
Buddy would like that. The spins up, please.
With that question, yes. And at the end of the day, it's always about spins. but, you know, my career as in promotion has lengthy, you know, from Beyonce to Metallica in my time. But coming to Hollywood Records was a shift for me in a lot of ways. And JOYWAVE was our first signing when I was there. And I love these guys. I really do. I've loved these guys from the very beginning, and it's been such a pleasure.
And with that heartfelt note, I think we should wrap this thing up and close the file.
That's it?
I think it was, unless you have more, that was such a nice finish. What else you want to add?
I just feel like I mucked this whole thing up. We didn't even get some good comedy out of this. Like
wait,
that.
I'm not done. I'm not done. The podcast is still going. I'm not
okay.
done.
Okay.
It still says recording, so
yeah,
keep going.
Yeah, it still says recording. Dave is learning, be careful who you book on your podcast right now. There's still a pandemic out there. I've got all the time in the world.
Okay, we'll squeeze in one more story, Dan. What is
when we were in Florida and we were doing a couple radio shows in a row, as you know, Dave, radio shows can be a little bit unusual or a strange mix of artists. So we found ourselves on a few of those in Florida with, can you hear that?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
You are in demand.
Toll free call. We were out with we're buddies with the guys in the band Bare Hands. And the last day I think was in Jacksonville, and we drove together, like we just like swapped vans to hang out and spend time with each other, and we decided that we were going to play our sets at the same time and have this fictitious disagreement about whose turn it was to play. Both of our crews are really good sports about like this is going to be very funny, so we both went out and played our songs over the top of one another. And me and Dylan, the singer from their band, went back and forth about, no, I'm pretty sure that we're on at, you know, 5 o'clock. And they're like, no, I'm pretty sure we're on at 5 o'clock. So we had this fight, and then we agreed to take turns back and forth. So it was this monstrous setup of like 11 people on stage and way too many channels to the audio. And the radio station was like, what the hell is happening here? This is not what we intended. And I don't remember if it was Buddy calling me or who it was, but it was many people calling me saying, please don't play over the top of another band at the same time at the event. And the audience was like, what the hell is this? And so, we, you know, we went back and forth song for song. And, you know, that was a pretty good song, but check this one out, like a battle back and forth.
People
and
didn't love that? That sounds fantastic.
Some people did. And then at the end, it turned out the station really liked it because it was, you know, memorable.
Yes.
And to that point, I will say there have been other instances where the label, me, others, would be like, no, you guys can't do that. You can't do, well, guess what? That turned out to be such an epic event that people talked about that from market to market. You know, it became not only a talking point, but people loved it. They got a kick out of it. And that is the part, what I was talking about, is they just went for what they believed in and they continue to. So I respect that. And they push the limits.
If you're not entertaining yourself, you're doing it wrong.
So true. And with that, we are going to close the file on JOYWAVE. My thanks to Dan, Buddy, and Bailey for joining us on this inaugural podcast. I'm Dead Air Dave. We'll catch you next time with more inside info on the Kiss Kiss Bang Bang new music files powered by Osiris Media. Our theme song is written and performed by Los Angeles band Love Ghost.